The second of two homecoming games for the Pecatonica Argyle football team, this one for the Argyle half of the co-op at Community Park in Argyle. It's not only homecoming, but it's a huge Six Rivers Conference game between Peck Argyle and Potosi, who come into the day tied for first atop the conference standings. We pick this one up in the third quarter with Potosi on the march down 14-6. Kyle Kaiser finds Daniel Post for a 22-yard gain down to the Peck Argyle 7. Brent Curtis scores on the next play, and all of a sudden it's a two-point ball game midway through the third quarter. After Riley Hawes' 68-yard catch and run gives Potosi a 20-14 lead, Peck Argyle executes a fake punt to keep a scoring drive of its own alive. Anthony Hendrickson goes up and comes down with this 12-yard grab over the middle, and then he goes deep for a 26-yard completion down to the Potosi 5. That sets up this 5-yard touchdown floater from Logan Green to Riley Osby, tying the game at 20 with 9:41 to play. The extra point try by Brooks Chandler sails just wide of the right upright, and we stay tied at 20. A little while later, Chandler pops up a punt trying to prevent a Potosi return. The ball takes a Chieftains bounce and winds up 6 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Potosi takes full advantage, getting a 12-yard run from Tegan Frederick down to the Peck Argyle 5 before Curtis takes it the rest of the way, scoring on a 5-yard run for a 26-20 Chieftains lead with 5.5 to play. The Vikings had one more chance to tie or take the lead, aided here by a pass interference penalty against Potosi. And Peck Argyle almost capitalized as Green's pass to Cam Trueheart goes off his fingertips in the end zone.
I saw it. That pass was really hard.
There was a defender right behind me. We were fighting a little bit, you know, like every pass. Okay. That was a good ball, one I should have had, and that was my mistake.
The Vikings ran out of chances, however, as Bryce McMahon bursts in and sacks Logan Green on fourth down to end the Peck Argyle threat. Potosi holds on 26-20.
I've been running the quarterback all around. I knew I just had one more chance and I'd get him, and that was the last chance, and I came up and I got him on that last one.
The Chieftains' work is not finished. They're at second place Belmont next
Mark,
week.
Mark, nothing against you, but I think there's a lot of teams in the conference that'll be big Belmont fans next week. So how do you deal with that, and how do you deal with the one more real tough game in this conference?
Well, you know, I think it helps us, really, because we've been building for this. You know, we've been building for this. It's almost like a little mini playoff run before the playoff run. It's a conference championship playoff run, and that's kind of what we've been talking about. Just taking it one at a time. And, I don't know. Our kids, I know they're enjoying this, but I know for a fact they'll be focused and ready to come back on Monday. Right.
You know, we would be a tough ball game coming in here. We're prepared for that. They made a few more plays than we did, and a little bit up front, a little more physical than we were. At times that got pressure on us, and we thought we'd be able to get open.
Also brought to you by Country Kids, and it just didn't work that way.